In this video, we're going to talk about nuclear chemistry. When we've talked about chemical reactions in the past, we've always talked about reactions that take place with the electrons, either the transfer or sharing of electrons in ionic and covalent bonds. But when we talk about nuclear chemistry, we're talking about reactions that happen in the nucleus of an atom. So let's start off with a quick isotope refresher. Hopefully you remember what this isotope symbol means, but just as a reminder, the top number, 235, is the mass number, which is equal to the sum of the protons plus the neutrons in the atom. And the bottom number is the atomic number, which is the number at the top of the periodic table block, and that's equal to the number of protons. And we want to remember that all atoms of the same element have the same number of protons. So that's how we know which element is which. And atoms of the same element can have different numbers of neutrons and therefore different mass numbers. So you probably remember that from way back at the beginning. We call those atoms with different numbers of neutrons and different mass numbers isotopes. That's how we distinguish. You can also remember that we call atoms with different numbers of electrons ions. We don't need to worry about that too much in this unit, but just a reminder. All right, so let's talk about what happens in the nucleus. Not all combinations of protons and neutrons are created equal. They're not all really stable. And so what happens is some are more unstable, and when that happens, they'll do one of the following things. They can either undergo what's called radioactive decay, they can also undergo nuclear fission or nuclear fusion. So nuclear reactions, they have some things in common with reactions that you've done in the past, but they're definitely going to look different. So one thing that they have in common is nuclear reactions still have to be balanced. So here's what a nuclear reaction looks like. This is a good example. Think about what must be balanced on this reaction, what things you think must be balanced. Hopefully you recognize that 238 on the left, the mass number for the uranium, is equal to the 4 plus the 234 on the right. That's mass balance. Remember, those top numbers are the mass numbers. And then the bottom number, the 92 on the left for the uranium, that is equal to the 2 plus 90 on the right. That's how we charge balance it. Remember that that is the number of protons in each of those isotopes. So we add the mass numbers to give the same mass number on both sides and say that it's mass balanced. And then we make sure that the atomic numbers on both sides add up to make it charge balanced. We're not writing it with atoms, we're just representing what's happening in the nucleus. That's all we care about. The electrons are there, but that's not where the reactions are taking place. So let's take a look at what's called radioactive decay. And that's the first way that we said that atoms that are unstable can stabilize themselves. When an atom undergoes radioactive decay, it no longer is the same element. It's very random. Nothing allows us to really predict, and we can't change when an atom decays. And there are two main types of radioactive decay. There's alpha decay, and then there's beta decay. There are actually more than two, things like positron emissions and proton emissions and things like that, but we're not going to worry about that in this class. These are the only ones you need to really understand at this point. So with alpha decay, remember alpha is a Greek letter, that's an emission of what's called an alpha particle from the nucleus. And the alpha particle is a helium-4 nucleus. So we have to write out a reaction for something that undergoes alpha decay. When we write a helium nucleus, remember that helium has an atomic number of 2 and then a mass number of 4. So that's how we'll write a helium nucleus. And when we write a reaction, here's an example, uranium-235, which is what we call enriched uranium, if you have ever heard of that in a news story, it decays by alpha decay. So we start off by writing the isotope symbol for uranium-235. So remember, uranium has an atomic number of 92, and of course the 235 from the uranium-235 is its mass number. And then when we say that it decays, we go ahead and write the arrow, and then we write the helium nucleus because we know that it has split off the helium nucleus from the uranium nucleus. And then what we have to do is figure out what's left. So let's look at that. We know that on the right, everything has to balance with what's on the left. So you want to look at this and say, okay, in order to get 235, I have to think about what number I need to add to 4 to get that. So hopefully you're thinking, 231. And then on the bottom, you see that 92 is on the left, so we need 92 on the right. We've got a 2 here. We need a 90 on the bottom. And in order to figure out the symbol for that, remember that the 90 tells us the atomic number. So look at your periodic table, and you'll see that 90 is thorium. So we're going to show that the helium nucleus plus thorium with a mass number of 231 to give us our balanced reactions. On the left side, the uranium is the reactant, and on the right side, those two, thorium and the helium nucleus, are our products. That's the alpha particle that was emitted, and we want to make sure that we look at our mass and charge balance to get our other product. So we just have to kind of think through the fact that it's going to kick off this helium nucleus, and then we can determine using our mass and charge balance what the other product is. So these are not super difficult, you just have to kind of be careful with your math. Let's talk about beta decay. So beta decay, the emission of a beta particle from the nucleus. And a beta particle is an electron. And hopefully you can remember that electrons, in comparison to protons and neutrons, have a really tiny mass. So in essence, it's zero. And the electron, when it comes to charge, remember that it is a negative one. This is how we represent this. The minus might not be shown, but it really should be. So when you look at thorium-231, that was the product of our alpha decay reaction that we just did. It decays by beta decay. So remember, we're going to start off with the thing that's decaying on the left, and then we're going to draw an arrow, and we're going to show that that beta particle is on the right side of the arrow. So here's our beta particle, our electron there. And then we need to just, again, do the same thing where we mass balance and charge balance our reaction. So we need to figure out what we add to zero to get 231, and you can see that that'll be 231 on the top, and then what we add to negative 1 to get 90. So be careful with this one, it's a little trickier. It's going to be 91. 91 minus 1 will give you 90. So if you thought 89, be really careful with those negative signs. And so you'll have 91 on the bottom, 231 on the top, and when you look on your periodic table, the element that has an atomic number of 91 is Pa, protactinium. So you can see that we've got, again, another mass balanced and charge balanced reaction. Remember that the sum of the things on the left has to equal the sum of the things on the right. So let's go ahead and take a look at this reaction, beta decay by cesium-137. Go ahead and pause the video. Start off with your cesium-137, draw the arrow, and then the beta particle, and see if you can figure out the other product of the reaction. Then start the video and check your answer. Also, alpha decay by polonium-210. So, polonium-210 on the left, draw your arrow, and then show the alpha particle on the right. Okay, so let's try this. So cesium-137, when you look that up, cesium with a mass number of 137, and we know cesium's atomic number is 55, and remember, we'll draw the arrow, and then our beta particle is that electron. So it's an electron, and negative 1 on the bottom, 0 on the top, and then we're going to show what we need to add to that to get the same mass and charge balance. So we're going to need 137 on the top, and on the bottom, remember, we're going to need to add 1 to 55, so it's going to be 56, and that is barium. Hopefully you're looking at this and thinking, not too bad. Let's try this other one. Polonium-210, it's polonium PO with a mass number of 210, and then its atomic number is 84, and then that alpha decay is that helium nucleus, so helium with an atomic number of 2 and a mass number of 4. And then remember to mass and charge balance, so 206 on the top. And then we're going to have 82 on the bottom to add to 2 to give us 84. And atomic number 82 is lead. So I hope you did well with that, and we will go from there. I do want to show you something called a decay series, because nuclei undergo multiple decays. So sometimes in order to become stable, you'll have something like uranium-238, which will actually decay into thorium, then protactinium, then uranium-235. And then they will continue to decay to another isotope of thorium, radium, radon, polonium, and so on, eventually ending up at lead-206. So what happens is that decay series will tend to occur until it ends in something stable, and many of them will end in lead. A few of them will end up in bismuth, which is next to lead. Everything that is higher than bismuth is radioactive. Bismuth and polonium are the closest stable elements to lead. So just wanted to share that with you, and I'm going to end with a cartoon. Hope you enjoy this, and I'll see you in class.